47-year-old Linda Dykes is an obsessive cleaner from North Wales.
Have I been called OCD? Oh, you'd better believe it.
Obsessed by shine, Linda spends one whole month a year just making taps sparkle.
What can shine will shine.
And she cleans around the clock, whatever time of day or night.
5:30 in the morning, and I start getting the bloody Hoover out and the mop and getting the washing up done and, you know.
And Linda is not alone. A quarter of people in Britain are so obsessed with cleaning and tidying that they spend 2.5 hours or more every weekday on household chores, with many feeling compelled to abide by strict regimes and rituals.
I don't wash my bath with my hands because I just think dead skin cells and stuff probably stick.
These towels have got to be in sync with each other.
But for most of us, keeping our homes clean and tidy is not a priority, as the average kitchen chopping board has 3 times as much fecal bacteria as the average toilet.
There's a dog poo on the carpet.
He's never done that before.
And over 500,000 of us wash our sheets just 3 times a year.
Oh, good God. I'm actually lost for words.
Linda Dykes believes people with an obsessional need to clean their home have a special set of skills which could change the habits of a nation.
Right then, should we crack on?
Yeah.
Come on.
So, she's teaming up with an army of obsessive cleaners.
Together, we will clean up Britain.
Right now, my OCD, the fact that there's poo on the toilet seat, my hands absolutely sweating.
Filthy, 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 filth.
But can two sets of people with opposing attitudes to cleanliness help each other and transform their lives?
I've never, ever seen anything like it. It actually made me feel sick.
In her quest for excellence, Linda Dykes is personally inspecting the homes of the volunteer army of obsessive cleaners.
Hi, Christy. Hi.
What can I say?
Perfect.
Yes.
I'm going to have a little look in your oven.
Oh, my goodness.
Spotlessly clean.
Her first recruit is 54-year-old Denise from Richmond, who was officially diagnosed with obsessive-compulsive disorder in 2002. Her life is ruled by a series of rituals.
I would just go 9:10, 9:10, 9:10. Then I can move on.
It's like something's pushing me. Do it. You've got to do it. And it's like something in the back, in my back, and it's in my head saying, just check it, and then it's clear. Just check it.
Denise spends time in her home continually polishing, tidying and cleaning. She spends up to 3 hours a day dusting and has a particular anxiety about ornaments.
A lot of people like ornaments and that, but to me, I look at them and I think, oh, did they dust them? Have they cleaned them? Is there germs? So I prefer to have nothing.
Denise runs a pub with her sister, where her compulsive rituals continue to dominate her life.
See, I have these enforced. Actually, see, that's not enforced. See, someone's playing games here. All the labels have to face the right way, even though they're in the crate. Straight lines, tidiness is part of OCD. And in my head, it makes me feel clean and tidy.
Denise was initially embarrassed by her OCD, but having come to terms with it, she's keen to share something positive from the experience.
I was ashamed of OCD because I actually thought, am I a bit crazy? I can't help it. It's who I am. It's I like tidy things and it's the way I live.
Denise is taking 4 days out of her own obsessive cleaning regime to try and help a complete stranger get their own house in order.
I've never, ever been into a dirty house in my life. I have this fear and my hands are sweating now, but I bought my gloves, so I'll be okay.
Good morning.
Good morning. I'm Denise.
And I am Frank.
Frank is an 81-year-old retired British aerospace engineer.
Cleaning is one of the least of my priorities. And I have so many interests. Perhaps in some cases I develop the interest to put off the cleaning.
Since his wife died 9 years ago, Frank's 3-bedroom house has gradually disappeared beneath piles of clutter.
I suppose some people would take the drugs. It just happened that I took to collecting rubbish. I have to recognise that it is out of control.
Frank's passion is physics and has a collection of scientific equipment hidden amongst the clutter, proving that one man's junk is another man's treasure.
Now, this is my favourite, an oscilloscope. I have a special love for this. In fact, I could caress it.
He may be attached to his clutter, but at 81, he's turning his home into a potential death trap.
The probability of me tripping over something is getting higher and higher. It needs to be done, it has to be done, or I'm going to put my clogs as a result of it.
Okay. Oh my God. Whoa. Frank, oh my gosh.
How long have you lived like this?
It's been developing, about 9 years, in fact.
Oh, my God.
This is a mess, but it is my mess. And I guess I've come to accept it.
How do you sit at the table and have dinner?
With difficulty.
I think so. Great difficulty.
Perhaps you'd like to see the mess of the kitchen now.
Let's go through to the kitchen.
Frank.
Oh, my word. This is bad. This is really, really bad. And if you don't mind me saying, this is the worst house I've ever been in my life.
Well, I don't know whether to accept that as a compliment or... But,
well, it's not just untidy, Frank. It's actually so, so dirty. So dirty. Mm.
To the best of my knowledge, I cannot recall having food poisoning.
No. I've never, ever seen anything like it. It wasn't just clutter. It was so, so dirty. It actually made me feel sick.
Oh, my God.
Frank. You stand in that bath?
I shower in that bath every morning.
Do you ever clean your bath?
I have rubbed around it, but I have to say I haven't actually...
Frank, you have not. What do you clean it with, Frank? Quickly,
well,
what do you clean
really
it with?
I've never put any exactly. bath cleaner on it, no.
No.
Back in the living room, Denise wants to understand how things got so bad.
Why won't you... Why wouldn't you... Why... I just...
When
I can't...
you see something happening on a very gradual basis, you don't notice any change at all. And... if I did have an accident here, which is all too easy, there's no way I'd be left back in.
No. They'd put you in a home or somewhere, won't they?
And that would kill me straight off.
Yeah.
There's no possible way I'd survive yeah. with a group of old layabouts.
He's such a lovely man, and he's just lost his way, and he just needs a little bit of help. Poor man.
Expert cleaner Linda Dykes has turned her obsession into a business and believes people obsessed by cleaning have a special set of skills which could help clean up Britain.
Everybody needs a kick up the bum that doesn't clean.
We will clean up Britain.
The next volunteer is 22-year-old hairdresser Adam, who's obsessed with symmetry and balance.
Each of these side candles is in the very centre of each of the posts because the lines on that carry on straight up through the candle and then through the side of the mirror. So that balances out. It's a much more calming feeling if everything's perfectly in order. In terms of mess and disorder and chaos, there's no need for it. There's no need for it. Everything has a place. And if it goes back in its home, then balance and order has been restored. You can't have one over on this side because it's mainly your right hand that you get them with. So it has to be over on that side, next to each other, perfect. If it's not placed in the perfect place, I don't feel comfortable. It's just it ticks on my head all the time. That's all I think about.
To help keep his mind calm, Adam prefers clean, clear surfaces. Any remaining objects must be precisely positioned and exactly aligned, He can spend up to an hour of every day just tweaking objects in his house.
You can't be placed like that. Look, that just looks awful. Look at that. But that way, everything's smooth, everything's fine. Now the plug's little triangle has to face into the plug hole. That's how a sink should be organised. I am quite over the top. I know I am, but I don't care.
Because I can easily... Adam's partner, James, knows how Adam struggles if he isn't able to perform his rituals.
If Adam doesn't get what he needs to do done, he will get anxious. His body language will change, and the anxiousness will always continue until it's done.
Adam is relishing the chance to bring balance to someone else's chaos.
Definitely, my way is definitely the right way. Anyone else's way is just a half-assed way of doing things. My way is the right way.
Adam's going to take 4 days away from his perfectly aligned home to help someone he's never met before. Helen is a 54-year-old police horse volunteer who lives alone in Buckinghamshire with her dog and two cats.
If I had a list of priorities, cleaning and tidying would be at the bottom. Life's too short to spend hours and hours cleaning my house.
It's not just the lack of cleaning that's the problem. Over the years, Helen has hoarded piles of stuff from old clothes to paperwork and a vast collection of antique horse bits.
Because there is so much stuff, you can't actually really get to it to clean it.
Helen feels that if she carries on hoarding for much longer, she'll go past the point of help and lose control of her home.
I've just lost the plot, really. And I think recognising that in myself is important. And I need to do something about it.
Adam's come to Buckinghamshire in the hope that his balanced and minimalist philosophy can revolutionise Helen's life.
Hello, how are you?
No, I'm not too bad.
I'm Helen.
I'm Adam. Nice to meet you.
This is the living room. A little bit cluttered.
There's, it's quite unbalancing. I think it's mainly just because there's like boxes of stuff and it's...
I can tell you're totally out of your comfort zone.
I am, a little bit, I am, yeah. Definitely. See, because I can't relax.
I get the real feeling that you're totally uncomfortable here.
It does make me feel a bit...
uneasy?
A little bit. Little bit. I'm clean. And I'm in a non-clean environment, and it's just... wow. Doesn't make me feel good. I walk in there and I'm just like, oh, no, 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 I don't like it. Oh, good God. This is where you sleep.
Yeah. It's virtually all I do, sleep and store clothes.
Definitely store clothes. Definitely. See, everything feels like it's closing in. I'm actually lost for words. I couldn't live in this room.
Britain's public spaces need help. Over 2.25 million pieces of litter are dropped each day, and over £100 million worth of damage is caused by graffiti each year. But obsessive professional cleaner Linda Dykes believes that the task force of compulsive cleaners can help to bring Britain up to her own high standards.
As OCD people can make things better, and with the help of the community, we can make Britain a better place.
Today, she's taking on the challenge of cleaning up a Victorian underpass in Redhill, Surrey, which is in dire need of help.
The thought of it is giving me the heebie-jeebies already. I'm thinking of urine, litter, graffiti, damp, dirty. You name it, it could all be in there.
This tunnel links Redhill train station to the heart of the town and is used to avoid the busy road.
Cutting through the tunnel is a bit hit and miss. It's quite dirty. I don't like all the graffiti.
Litter and graffiti are major problems, but with Network Rail having to reduce their budget by £4 billion by 2014, there are no resources to clean up the tunnel. So local councillor Jonathan Essex is grasping the opportunity Linda's providing with both hands.
There's a real opportunity here to take a space from its current state into one that's loved and becomes part of our community again.
The underpass is a mammoth task, so joining Linda today are fellow obsessive cleaners Michelle and Chaser.
Here's a tunnel.
Mum of two, Chaser, is so hygiene-obsessed, she washes her hands up to 60 times a day.
I spend half my life washing my hands. When I leave the house, I wash my hands, and I get home, I wash my hands. It is a pain in my life, but I just can't help it.
Michelle has such a fear of germs, she cleans her house for up to 8 hours a day.
I could polish my kitchen floor easily 4 to 5 times a day.
I recognise that I'm crazy with the cleaning, but I can't help it. There is no other way.
It's bad down here, isn't it?
It's not nice, is it?
No.
It's not a pleasurable walk.
Glass as well on the floor.
What does rubbish bring? Animals, creatures.
And there's poo.
Oh, my God. It makes me feel sick when I see cobwebs and animals and anything that's crawling. Can't stand
Watch
it.
Out for the rats then above.
Can't stand it. I'll be gone. I will be gone. If there's rats, I will be gone.
Behavioural psychologists believe that a dirty environment can magnify antisocial behaviour. If a place looks messy and uncared for, then the higher the risk for further damage and vandalism.
It is pretty grim in there. It's not pleasant. You wouldn't want that to be a journey home every day. Like, you could get dirty water in your hair and glass everywhere. It's just not safe.
I physically feel sick at the moment. I feel like my skin is crawling. I feel dirty in there. I just feel like it's all grubby and smelly. It just feels like a tunnel of a toilet.
It may have Chaser and Michelle on edge, but Linda is determined.
We will make a difference, purely for the fact that we're not scared of hard work and we will do the job properly. We will not leave here until it's done. It will be complete.
It's obsessive-compulsive Denise's first day in Chipping Sodbury. Her strategy is to reduce the trip hazards in 81-year-old Frank's home that hasn't been tidied up in nearly 10 years. So clearing the living room is a priority.
I've got a system here. That's all kitchen. Obviously, we can't put it in the kitchen because we can't get into the kitchen. This is all charity. That over there is like his new shoes and stuff that he probably doesn't even know he's got.
There are many reasons why people hoard, such as bereavement. But psychologists suggest that some of the UK's 3 million hoarders do so instinctively. Just as squirrels hoard nuts, there's an evolutionary benefit to collecting as much stuff as possible.
Frank, why have you got so many tissues? Boxes and boxes and boxes of tissues.
Well, I'd forgotten I'd bought them, I suppose. And I tend then to buy things and overbuy. And that's, I think, where it all goes wrong.
OK, so do you just buy stuff because it's cheap and you just think you're...
I generally get things when they're on offer and you end up by having far more than you need.
This is just a few.
I suppose it's the difference between what you need and what you want.
Yeah, but you don't want or need all these tissues.
Well, I want but all these tissues, but I don't need them.
Denise's OCD means that she spends up to 21 hours a week dusting her home to keep it dirt-free. And in Frank's, she feels the compulsion to take steps to protect herself.
I feel safe now. I don't know why, but... OK, let's just go for it. I think we're going to have to pull the old settee out, actually.
But it's not just the living room that's a trip risk for Frank. The kitchen also needs clearing out.
OK, Frank, I don't want you to see what I'm doing. Maybe you start over there, look. Frank, over there.
Right.
Now, please don't keep food. Mm. And this is all out-of-date food.
Right.
Go, please. Am I getting at you a bit?
I think you got at me from the beginning, but I couldn't be got at by a nicer person.
Oh, bless you, Frank.
If you don't use it, throw it out. That's her fixation, and I appreciate that.
We've got one of those, Frank. Yeah, well done.
I think of Denise rather like Marilyn Monroe with a 303 rifle. Where did you find her?
To be honest, what I could have done when I come in here is just got all hold of all the stuff and put them all in the cupboards and just close the doors. But that's not how I work. I would be thinking what that cupboard looks like inside. That is an OCD problem. But it's just the way I am. I just like everything straight, and I'm going to do that for Frank. I'm determined to do that for Frank.
In Buckinghamshire, Adam is making a start on Helen's cluttered home. Since he only has 4 days and no extra help, Adam's decided to tackle the bedroom, living room and dining room, as these will make the biggest immediate difference to Helen's daily life.
So by the end of today, what we're going to achieve is a clean, spacious living room.
His strategy is to skip what clutter Helen will allow and store away what's left.
That's cat pee. The cats use this as a toilet. The cats use the house as a toilet.
Since accidentally getting shut in the living room while Helen was away, the two cats have been using the carpet as a litter tray.
How did you feel when you found it? Could you smell it before you... Well, of course you could smell it before you could
see it. Oh, it came in and just... It was just all over
the place. It was just that strong.
Yeah. Yeah, that's bad.
But they must have used it that much. It's actually yellow as well.
And maybe I think it's turned that colour as well because of stuff I've used on it. I admit it. Hands up. Not nice. He probably hates it. He probably doesn't want to be here, to be honest, but I'm going to ignore that.
It's just a case of, like... Yeah, his cat pee behind the chair. It's like, what? And that doesn't... And you don't think that's, like, a big thing?
All efforts to sort it have failed, and the carpet is going to have to be industrially cleaned. But one thing they can tackle now is the TV stand.
I've never, ever, ever seen a TV cabinet this bad. Ever. Anything you move, the dust just plumes into the air, and you can't not breathe it in.
Do you want me to get in there? Are you happy to do this?
Oh, no, I'm going to clean it, but I'm going to show you how to do it. I'm going to talk you through it.
That's fine, but you don't need to talk me through it. I know how to clean.
Well, maybe not a case of talking you through it, then, just to see the difference.
I'm not being defensive, but I don't understand why you have to analyse it. Because to me, it's just dust.
Why does it not matter? It's...
I don't know, because I don't need to or want to analyse it.
See, because I think of the bigger picture, things that it could lead to. You're breathing it in. You don't know what's in the dust. It could be anything. And if the cats are breathing it in, God knows what that could lead to for the cats.
It's really ingrained in you, isn't it?
Yeah.
That you can't...
Because that's filthy.
Yeah.
Simply just because it's filthy. Now that the stuff is being sorted, it's the dirt and the sheer massive clean that we're going to need to do. It's a lot more than I ever thought it was going to be.
In Redhill, it's the day of the big clean.
Hi, guys.
Linda's working with two other cleaners, Chaser and Michelle, to help the community sort out their Victorian underpass.
Are you all ready to go for this challenge and get in there and start cleaning?
Yes. That wasn't good enough. Are you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mind the steps, guys. They're a bit slippy.
As Linda puts half the volunteers to work scrubbing the bricks...
I want all this off the walls purely because walking down here isn't a nice experience when you've got damp screaming at you.
The other half start picking litter.
One of the ladies is a bit scary. The one with the short hair, she's bossing everyone about.
I'm struggling for the dust. My nose is getting runny now. Michelle, is all the dust bothering you?
Yeah,
it's
fine.
My throat feels a bit itchy, yeah.
My throat's dry. I think it's from all the particles that we're just breathing.
Yeah, and also every time you sweep, you get dust in your face,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah, definitely.
Now the sweeping and litter pick are complete, Linda wants to smarten up the brick walls. The industrial-strength jet washer won't get rid of the graffiti, but it will obliterate the ground in dirt.
Are you sure you don't want your suits on?
No, thanks. I've had one of them on before. It takes forever to get it on. No.
I prefer not to get wet.
Daisy, are you ready?
Yes.
Right, OK.
Obsessive cleaners may have special skills, but being in a filthy environment can dramatically raise their anxiety levels, and their responses can vary.
She's dangerous!
Look at you. All that filth that you've just been spraying is all on your hair. How are you going to cope with that? All the filth from above was all flying onto us. I just felt like gunge coming all over me, and I hate my hair to be messy, I hate my skin to be dirty.
I don't mind grottiness, to be honest. I'm a cleaner. You know, you've got to expect to come across filth.
Oh, my God, look down. One minute. Ugh. Ugh. You're just covered in it.
Yeah, but I enjoyed it.
I know you enjoyed it. I've got the mess you're in, though.
But I can sort my mess out.
See,
I know.
That's why I wear suits, so then I can do as much work as I want, not worry about what's underneath.
Look, it'll go in the wash. I know, but it's all sitting on you right now.
It is sitting on me.
I just want to take your scarf off and shake your scarf off and just chuck it away.
Oh, my this. God, look at your jacket.
Oh, God. See?
We're all in a sorry state.
Terrible, absolutely terrible.
I'm not.
In Buckinghamshire, Adam's finding out more about how Helen's house got to be so dirty and cluttered.
I've done nothing with the house really over the past year. Lost my husband about 5 months ago to cancer.
Right.
He's been ill. So didn't really get a lot of time to do, you know, housework. Because obviously all my time was devoted to, you know, doing as much as we could for Tom while he was still here.
Of course, yeah.
But now, maybe, time to move on. Time to move forward and...
Onward and upward.
Yeah.
To help Helen move forward, Adam's come up with a simple strategy to tackle the piles of clothes she's been holding on to in the bedroom.
The inbox is everything you want to keep.
Mm-hmm.
The outbox, give them to charity. The later box is anything that you can't really decide on straight now. Let's get sorting.
There's around 3 million hoarders in the UK, but the reasons why people hoard are unclear. It may be genetic or triggered by trauma. Whilst it can cause distress and isolation, research suggests the hoard can also provide considerable comfort.
When was the last time you wore that?
God knows.
So why are you keeping it?
Because I made it. Next.
At home, Adam demands empty space and clear surfaces, and by clearing away the mess, he feels more in control and his anxiety is reduced.
When was the last time you saw the floor? You have to think about it.
That
was
over a year ago.
Over a year? You've not seen that patch of carpet for a year?
No.
Why?
Because of the things on it.
It baffles me. It really does. It's brilliant getting stuck in and... just getting rid of stuff. It's me letting my OCs go crazy and just be able to sort stuff and clean stuff and get everything back in order. And in the same time, I'm helping someone who needs it. So, I'm having so much fun. Brilliant. Love it.
In Chipping Sodbury, Denise is clearing out the clutter from Frank's home to reduce the trip hazards. To do that, she's throwing away vast quantities of Frank's clutter and has already filled two skips.
Anything you want to keep goes in the box.
This is going to be a major job, this.
Upstairs, she wants to clean the room that bothered her the most, the bathroom. At home, Denise cleans her bathroom thoroughly with a toothbrush every single day.
Frank, I'm going to put my little pinny on. I want to put this on because, you know, bathrooms and...
Yes, you are paranoid.
Paranoid. Should we go?
Yeah. You first.
Thank you. Really. Oh, actually, this is bad.
Denise's OCD can result in strong physical reactions to certain triggers, like dirt and mould.
Frank. Frank. Yeah. Pick up your sponge.
You what? Sponge, right. That's going on here.
Oh, my God.
Right.
You didn't wash with that, did you, Frank?
What? No. I haven't used that for a very long time.
That was bad.
Lost your colour.
I've lost my colour. I think I might lose it again in a minute.
Oh.
The sponge is gone, but the bath, which hasn't been cleaned in 10 years, is next on the list.
Frank, I'm going to do it, OK?
No, Denise, I'll do that.
No, I'm... Oh. This is all germy. It smells as well.
But I use this every morning, huh?
How can you? I would feel like I was dirty when I got out.
Baths are one of the germ hotspots in a bathroom and can have up to 120,000 bacteria per square inch.
See? Oh, are they plasters? Oh.
These can be harmful and can include E. coli and Salmonella.
That's bad. Right. I'm not trying to make you feel bad, but... It just makes me feel so sick with the smell and the germs and this, like, skunky stuff. And the smell, it just turns my stomach.
Well, I'm going to get the worst of that up now.
Maybe if anyone's ever had a panic attack, which I have, that's how it makes me feel at the moment, a bit like that.
I think she was pretty well overwhelmed this morning. Her obsessive compulsion may be considered an illness or even a detraction. For me, it's an asset. It's an asset in the sense that I know that what she says, she believes, and when she does something, she does it with great gusto.
Oh, my word, look at that. I'm really surprised that I didn't just walk out, but it's a challenge and it's also to help me, to help Frank. But I'm glad I've done it now. Because I'm not... It hasn't done anything to me, it hasn't harmed me. It just actually makes me just feel a bit queasy, really.
In Buckinghamshire, the professional carpet cleaners have arrived to clean Helen's carpet. The floors were ruined after the cats were accidentally shut in the living room. But a job this big can only be done by the professionals.
So nice to see all the stains gone and just to keep the cleaning going, keep the momentum going, and maybe this will spur us on to keep going a little bit more.
There's little they can do while the carpet cleaners are at work, so 22-year-old Adam and 62-year-old Helen head out for a break. Things may have been difficult since Helen's husband Tom passed away 5 months ago, but Adam suspects the cluttering problems started before then.
Would you consider yourself as a hoarder?
Oh, I'm definitely a hoarder. Yeah, absolutely. I just literally get stuff in and I just don't move it on.
So over time it's been obviously like collecting things to not finding the time to get rid of the old stuff to bring the new stuff in, and then...
To not wanting to get rid of the old stuff.
Not wanting... Oh, right, okay. See, I can't get my brain around not wanting to. Do you gain anything from it? Or do you have a reason for doing it?
Do I gain anything from it? I suppose it's a negative gain in that I don't have to cope throwing things away. And I think that throwing things away are going to be quite painful.
Yeah?
Yeah, because I'm attached to the stuff.
Yeah.
So now it's something I know I've got to do.
Yeah.
Having spent 3 days with Helen, Adam has managed to get her to the point where she can let some stuff go. To make it as painless as possible, they've decided to donate Helen's old clothes to a charity of her choice.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
That's another bag.
Oh, that's very kind.
There's another bag there for you.
Super.
So how do you feel about letting some of it go?
Yeah, I don't mind. These were the people who looked after Tom.
Oh, right, OK.
Sorry, hang on.
You're right on.
Yeah. Give me a minute.
We were talking earlier about the choice of charity. She said she picked this one because it's the same charity that ran the hospital where she took Tom when Tom was really ill. That'd be a bit hard for her. But I think you're doing really, really well. I'm really, really, really proud of you.
It's windy, must be making my eyes water.
Yeah, something in your eye though, Helen.
Definitely, yeah.
But no, this is all good steps. Really good steps.
Oh, God.
Oh.
No, I'm all right. I'm all right, honestly. All right. Tom would have been proud of me.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, he would.
Definitely.
Yeah. Brought a lot of memories back today. It's just coming to terms with clearing the house out and everything that's gone on. Never losing memories, but just coming to terms with the whole process.
The Red Hill underpass may be free of litter and grime, but Linda's still not happy.
The only problem with the tunnel now is the graffiti, and it looks neglected, unloved, and not nice to walk through.
To solve the problem of this antisocial graffiti, she's called in a specialist company to cover the walls in anti-graffiti paint. This high-performance coating is easy to clean, as anything that's graffitied on top can be simply wiped off with water. Research has also shown that graphics and murals can deter graffiti by removing the blank canvas appearance, so coloured shapes are incorporated into the paintwork. After 2 weeks of painting, the cleanup is complete, and councillor Jonathan Essex is unveiling the underpass to the local community.
Thank you very much, and this tunnel is now reopened.
Nice.
It's a lot better, isn't it?
It got better.
The tunnel used to be a blot on the landscape, but after the cleaning team brought the community together, it's completely transformed.
I'm so proud. I think it looks absolutely amazing. It looks so much brighter, fresher. It just feels really nice and pleasant how a tunnel should be.
It's taken 400 man hours, but the paint company have eradicated the graffiti, and research has shown that clean, well-kept walls are more likely to be respected in the future.
Making the walls lighter gives a more of an open space.
Yeah, feeling, it feels bigger, doesn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
It feels bigger.
We needed that obsessive cleaners to come in here and do something, and getting them to push us to come and do it really did make the difference to the tunnel.
My OCD has paid off an awful lot for the community. You know, we've all done so much down here that has been so good. We've made a huge difference.
The three cleaners came down just 2 weeks ago, and they've led us, and they've shown us what's possible.
Well, girls, we did it!
I know.
That was amazing!
Group hug.
Without our obsession and love for cleaning, this would never have happened today. You know, the proof is always in the pudding, isn't it? And here is the pudding. We have a nice, walkable little palace.
After 4 days in Helen's Buckinghamshire home, the clearing out and cleaning up is complete, and Adam is in his element.
Tall, small, tall, small, tall. That's fine. Yeah. But that's the taller one. So I think that should go in the middle and create, like, a pyramid effect.
Do it.
Adam's obsession with symmetry demands that everything he can see is balanced and positioned exactly.
It has to be perfect centre, does it?
Now I'm using each tip of this. Just looks like it's sitting on their shoulders. That to you makes no difference, does it?
Not a jot, but I probably have gone, well, you know, bring that one forward a bit, or bring that one to that one there, like that, and make it rather curved rather than linear. So that's difficult for me to understand why that makes you happier to place it that millimetre to the left or right than where I had it.
But it's because I can see it.
Because you can see it and I can't.
I can see it, yeah.
Now that everything's positioned perfectly, hairdresser Adam has one final makeover he wants to achieve.
We've got your house looking gorgeous, and this is why I'm doing this for you, because I'm going to get you looking gorgeous as well.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
With Helen and her home ready, her son Rob, who grew up in the house, is keen to see the finished result.
You want to come in and have a look?
Yeah, okay.
See your
hard work. Let's go.
4 days ago, Helen's living and dining room were so cluttered and chaotic that cleaner Adam felt uncomfortable and tense when he first walked in.
Right, you ready for this?
Oh, my word, I can hear an echo. That's how little stuff there is in here. I can actually hear an echo.
Helen has confronted her emotional attachment to clutter, and now the entire downstairs area is transformed. The cat pee stains have gone, and with Adam's careful positioning, empty space and balance reign.
It's about as minimalist as I think you will ever, ever be.
That'll be music to Adam's ears. That's what he's trying to do to me.
Does it make you feel comfortable now?
It makes me feel
Are you calm?
I'm a lot more relaxed, a lot more relaxed. Calm than when I first came in, because when I first came in, I was very much like a cocoon, I was very closed off. But as time's gone on, I've just relaxed so much more.
Upstairs, Helen's unloved bedroom had become lost under piles of clothes.
My word, gosh. It does feel twice the size.
Isn't it fantastic?
It really does feel twice the size.
11 boxes and 5 bags of clothes have been cleared, and space has replaced the clutter, allowing Helen to reclaim her bedroom.
Having it uncluttered is lovely.
Mm.
So much better. It just looks so much better.
So I wouldn't go back. So, I mean, if I had a pile of clothes there now, I'd say, actually, that doesn't look good. This has given me so much freedom. It's almost as though I've gone through a curtain and it's just opened and I don't have to close the curtains back again.
Is this something that you're going to keep like this? Do you think you'll slip back, or are you determined to...?
I'm not going to slip back to how it was before. I won't promise it will be this spotless all the time. I will definitely make huge effort, and I'm going to set a cleaning regime up and so that I do stuff.
God, I'm happy to hear that. But I'm quite happy that I've been able to give you that ability to be able to get a cleaning regime and keep things on track, and I think you're going to be just fine.
I've not known much about OCD before and Adam's condition, but I don't think anybody else could have done it.
I'm feeling quite positive. I think Helen may just keep her word on some level. And who knows, maybe I've picked up a thing or two. Maybe I can drop a few things and not be so obsessive about certain things. But I don't think I'm that bad, really.
In Chipping Sodbury, Denise has been using her cleaning skills to bring order to Frank's house, and now the 4 days are over. Frank's great-niece, Katie, has come to see the results.
Would you like to lead the way?
Let's go.
Carry on,
Just 4 days ago, Frank's clutter covered every surface, and he was increasingly afraid of tripping and not being allowed to live in his home.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God, Frank!
It's taken 3 skips, 10 storage boxes and 8 rolls of bin liners, but now the living and dining rooms are clear.
I don't think I've ever seen it like that. Oh, my God, Frank, you can see your couch. Oh, it's amazing. It is.
God, you made me cry.
Thank you, Katie.
Frank's kitchen hadn't been thoroughly cleaned in 10 years, but now the dirt, grime and clutter have been eradicated.
God, you can see the cuteness. Oh, my days. It looks like a new sink. It's just amazing.
I think we could count what went out in hundreds weights.
We could, Frank.
Leaving you a ton of two.
Frank's bathroom was the hardest for Denise to face, as her OCD makes her intolerant to dirt and mould.
Look how clean that sink is. The bath is shiny.
It may have been her biggest challenge, but the 5 hours of cleaning has paid off, and Frank's bathroom is gleaming for the first time in 10 years.
with my OCD, this was probably one of the
hardest. Your worst nightmare?
Yeah. How I did it, I never know. This is for you, Frank, and you've got to enjoy it.
And I've got you to thank to a large extent as well, of course. But, please.
I said to him earlier, it's the first day of the rest of his life.
It is.
He's got to enjoy it.
It is.
Wasn't
it?
He's crying now. Hang on.
Are they clean?
Yeah.
I've left a very happy man behind. And he's got a lot of family and friends, so he's going to be absolutely fine.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Two words, thank you. I can't put it any better than that.
You've been a real friend.
We're keeping
touch. I am at peace with the world, almost.
I don't think I'll change how I live, because I like the way I live. I know I'm not going to die from a dirty cup, but I'm still not going to drink out of one, and I don't want one in my house either.
Next time on Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners.
These were bought for me when I was a baby and I'm not getting rid of these.
There's sentimental and there's just mental.
There's a dog poo on the carpet.
He's never done that before. And you said this plant can go?
No, not that one.
OK. These things are not going anywhere.
Well, if you have been affected by any of the issues in tonight's programme, or you'd like more information, search channel4.com for Obsessive Compulsive Cleaner. Well, life is full of little surprises, not all of them planned. One born is due in just a couple of minutes.